Morning, boys and girls. It's Wednesday. Today we're going to go to a stone yard in Kilkeel. And these are big stones brought in from different parts of the world. And from it, they're able to carve and make all sorts of sculpture and buildings and part of buildings. And we're going to learn all about that today. Let's sing the wee song, A Gift to You. Everything you do, do it heartily unto the Lord, the Bible says. Now we're going to go to Kilkeel to see some men hard at work, and it's amazing how they can make these sculptures and tombstones and all sorts of amazing structures out of stone. Let's go to Kilkeel.
Boys and girls, today we are in the Mourne Mountains in Kilkeel, but we've come to a stone factory, a company that's specialist in granite. Now, we've talked about stone walls before. You can see the stone walls all over the hills, all over the mountains to keep the animals together. And it's quite a feature here in the Kingdom of Mourne. And we're going to see how what they do with the stone, how they can cut it, how they can shape it, how they can what they do with it, and some of the places across the world where they actually take the stone to. And the stone here comes from many parts of the world. It comes from America, it comes from China, India, Finland, Sweden, Italy, Ireland, all across the world, under the earth, where there's stone, it can be dug up and used. There's sandstone, a softer stone, and then, of course, granite's a very hard stone. So to shape and to write on it, like a granite stone, it needs to be very, very strong so they can shape it and cut it. And we're going to see some of the things they actually do and how they make stone. So let's have a look. So like any business, they've got a reception, they've got an office, and we've just been there, and then we're going to go into the actual factory to see what they do with the stone and how they make it. This is McConnell & Sons here in Kilkeel, specialist in natural stone. Let's have a look. This is a typical stone where they could bring from some of those countries. They come in big, big containers, and of course the stone is cut up and shaped. You might think this is just a big stone, a big hard stone. It is just a big hard stone, but it's amazing. Whenever you think of a graveyard, you think of a tombstone, whether it's square or rectangular or round or oval. They've got machines to make any shape you want, and they can engrave onto the granite. It's different colours. It can be grey, it can be bronze, it can be red, it can be black. And in different parts of the earth, like a natural resource, they bring it up and bring it to here, into the factory, and now they can create anything they want. Some very famous landscapes across the world has been taken from Kilkeel to where they are. So here we're at the back of the factory, And whenever the stone arrives, it comes in big containers, and you can see it's in either in a cube or a square, or and it's all lined where it can be cut. There's sandstone, and there's marble. There's all different types of stone, all different shapes and sizes, colors. Some of it's very, very old. And for you, it just might look like an old stone, which it is. This is just like a big stone you'd find in the field, and there's some nice shapes. But the men in there have got machines, and they can shape the stone into any shape that they want to. And here, you've got some big cubes. It looks like a big fridge freezer. That's the way it's taken out from the quarry. Big cut into big squares, loaded onto a container, and it's brought here into the factory to be processed, to be cut into whatever shape they want it to be cut to. For example, it can be sliced. The first thing they often do is slice it. You can see here where they're cutting the stone. Big saw with the water lubricating it. And they're sliding it back and forward and back and forward, cutting the stone into slices. So here's some of the stone after it's come out have been cut. This is limestone. And then you've got sandstone, different colours of sandstone. And you can see the different grades and shapes and sizes and more limestone. And then you come to the granite, which is a really hard stone. And some of it's marble. Depending on the job, they have the stone for that particular job. But we're going to look a little bit closer at some of the grades. Look at the way this has been cut into different thicknesses. Look. Like sliced bread, and here's the different names. This is 100%. But look at some of the grains, and even this rock. People think this is millions of years old. The Bible talks about when God created the world about 6,000 years ago, and when God spoke, this world came into existence. Everything in the heavens, in the air, in the earth, and below the earth, it came into existence, created by the handiwork of God, because He just spoke. And you can see the marble. Nothing new under the sun. When you go into a kitchen, you see marble, you see granite, you see a kitchen table or a kitchen bench top. Where do you think that comes from? It comes from the earth, and it's brought into a company like this, a machine, put through a machine, and it comes out cut exactly into the shape of your kitchen. So you can see the different levels. This is marble, and you can see the different grades and the different grains. And I thought, just like these are all different, we are all different too, and there's a purpose for every one of these tops. Some for a kitchen top, some can be for a tombstone, some can be for an office. And like, God has a different plan and purpose for every one of us, but only until you give your heart and life to Him, you become one of His children, then God has a perfect plan for your life. And I think about the marble and the stone. Some of the stone's weak, like sandstone, not as strong as the granite, and some is very, very strong. And all of us are made differently. Some of us are physically weak. We've got a weakness. All of us are very strong physically. And some of us maybe aren't so good at school, and others are brilliant at school. So all of us are different shapes and sizes and colours. And inside we're different, the outside. But one thing's the same is the heart. And all of us have got a heart. Even though you can't see your heart, the Lord says, God says, my children, give me your heart. And when you give Him your heart, you're giving Him your life. And when you give Him your life, you're giving Him everything. And just like this granite needs to be shaped and needs to be designed and brought together, that's what God wants to do with you. Whenever you give Him your heart and give Him your life, just look at the side here. Look at the grains. This reminds me of a body, and the veins, how it's all connected together. You can't just take one of them out. It's part of it. Likewise, the veins in your fingers and your hands. Look at all this here, perfectly made stone. And just like your fingers, your hands, your blood vessels, your eyes, your nose, your ears, everything that makes up the human body, that's not designed by a man. That doesn't take millions of years to make. When God brought Adam and Eve, He simply made a man and made a woman, and it's by one man and one woman this whole world was populated. And you can trace your ancestors right back to Adam and Eve in the garden. That's what the Bible says. That's what God said. I believe it. And when you believe God, it makes life much more simpler, because you're not searching for answers, because God has the answers, and He's given us His word, the Bible. And faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the word of God. So whenever I think of the granite and the detail that is in a stone, how much more detailed are we? And we are created, yet we are created in the image of God. Just like some parts of the world, really wealthy people would use this in a really luxurious setting. Likewise, it can be used in your kitchen at home, all different stages and grandeurs in a home. which, but yet it all is traced right back to the earth. And in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. So even the stone can be traced right back to the handiwork of God. Look at this beautiful piece of stonework. And where does this come from? What country is renowned for being green? Ireland, yes. Away down the west of Ireland in Connemara, you'll find this stone, a natural colour, the natural green. Look how detailed and how lovely. We think an artist painted this stone, but yet this is a natural colour. So this can be used for coffee tables. If you go into hotels, some of the units in the hotels are made from this very marble. So when you walk in the hotel, you can see all the splendour and the beautiful texture of this material, but behind it is marble, a truly magnificent piece of work. So this saw here is a secondary saw, and it's cutting stone for use for pavement. It's cut the exact size, and here you've got the finished product. This is ready to be shipped to a job. This is granite stone cut into to be pavers for your driveway. You'll often see homes with gut pavement that can be red brick, but this is granite stone. You've got the normal brick, you've got the wee small sets, and it fits together to make a lovely drive. This here is marble. You can see the detail that is within this particular. It looks like a crown, but this factory here, whenever something is very, very old and it starts to crumble or maybe pieces break off it, it's brought here and they can fix it and make it look like new again. And that's like our lives. Sometimes we can do something wrong or something bad that we regret, but the Lord says, come to me without problem and I'll sort it for you. If you've done wrong, I'll forgive you for that, and I'll give you a new start and you can keep going. So he like fixes, he mends, he glues it together, and he says, keep going on with your life. Many people live in their life with regrets, and their lives are often ruined. But whenever you sin and do something wrong, tell the person you've done wrong to that you're sorry. Tell God your story. He said, I forget about it, and I'll not remember it again. So don't linger with those things. Just like this can be fixed and covered up. It's fixed, it's broken, but it can be fixed, and it still has a purpose to be used. And whenever it's reinstated to where its original building, you can see it in all its glory and how beautiful it is. And that's where God wants to see you. He wants to see you to be the best person you can be. And most of all, he wants his son Jesus to shine out of you in all his glory. So here we have sandstone. Sandstone is a much softer stone, which means it will not last as long as hard marble or hard granite. And this is sandstone. And you see the likes of the Albert Clock, or famous things around the country, around the world, are shaped and placed, and they really look beautiful, but they do decay, about 100 years maximum, and this will need to be replaced or need to be fixed. So there's nothing really permanent in this world. Even though a stone is so hard, and you think it's here to last forever, but nothing is going to last forever. This world, we are just passing through, and that's why this is a reminder. Even though that's perfectly shaped, you think nothing needs to be done, but this needs to be checked all the time for decay, or otherwise it will rot. Outside in the wind and the weather, it's only a natural stone, so it will naturally decay after some time. And our lives, the older we get, the more we will naturally decay. And that's why when you're young and you're strong and you're healthy, it's important to think about God and giving your heart to God and living for God, because one day we will all die, we will all rot. And that's why, just like stone, we need to be prepared to meet God and be ready. So we get old, we can be with God forever in heaven. Or maybe not old, when we're young, whenever we are prepared to meet God, we have our sins washed away, we can be with God anytime because he's always with us. So remember, even the stone and the natural decay of the stone over many, many years, nothing will last forever. So here we have some limestone, and one of the jobs that this was used for is Normandy in France. During the Second World War, when thousands of soldiers died in the war, a big monument has been made in Normandy to remember the fallen heroes of the war. But this limestone, it's easy to engrave. So you'll find all the soldiers' names will be engraven upon the limestone. And you can see some of the pictures, how it's so vast and so huge, but very solemn place where people can remember the fallen and the dead. It's important to remember history, and that's why this is very, very hard stone, and it will last for a long time. So in generations to come, children can be taught their history, how they can enjoy their freedom, because men have laid down their lives to fight for their freedom and for their country. And of course, it's a reminder, a solemn reminder, not just about where the limestone comes from. It comes from the earth. God created the heaven and the earth. But it reminds us of soldiers who laid down their life for freedom. And we can't miss the point about how the Lord Jesus, to give us freedom, he laid down his life that we can enjoy life and enjoy history, and most of all enjoy God and in everything that God has given to us in this earth to enjoy. Sometimes we can get so caught up with our schoolwork and so caught up with living and life, we can miss the purpose of life and the reason for life. And the reason for life is the one who gave his life so we can enjoy life, and that is life in his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Here we come to another part of the factory where there's a skilled craftsman, and he's working away here. You can see the face, the detail, and it's used by hand. Modern equipment, but it still has to be done by hand. And I thought, here's a craftsman, he knows exactly what he's doing whenever the stone comes. When the stone comes, it's just a big piece of stone. And I thought, that stone is like us. And many people see us as just a number, or just as a human being. But this man is interested in the detail of the stone, and that's what God does with us. He's interested in every detail of our lives. We're not just a number with God. We are a child. We can be a child of God. And his children, just like any father or mother, is interested in their children. God is interested in every detail of our lives. Not just your school, but whenever this comes into this man here, it just lies down, and the workman then works at every detail to make it out to be a perfect sculpture. And that's what God wants. He wants us to completely submit and to surrender to his ways and to his wills. Quite often we want to fight against that, and we want to do our own thing. But God says, don't struggle. Don't do your own thing. Allow me to help you and to be the best thing. I'm interested in all the details of your life. But just like this is stone, and the quantity and the quality of it used for something that is temporary, God is more interested in your life, because with our life, we can be doing things that will last forever, for eternity. So the secret today, when you think of the stone, we're thinking of the Creator God. And just like a stone is shaped into the purpose it's meant to be, God wants to shape us into what he wants it to be, and to be the person he wants us to be. But we must submit to the craftsman. We must submit to God and allow him to work in every detail of our lives to be the best person we can be for God. With today's technology, the company has advanced to great degrees, and have got a computer-controlled machine that can actually cut stone into the shape of a hand. And you can see this is part of a monument that's going to go in Dublin, and it's a lady holding a book in her hand. Look at the detail with the fingernail, and even the very veins in the hand and the fingers, and even the pages of the book. So technology today has advanced so much, nothing is really impossible. Although there are limits with it, but when I think about the Bible, what does God say about God? Man is limited to what he can do, but with God, nothing is impossible. We've just finished our talk here in Kilkeel in the stone factory, and we've come across into part of the factory, and I thought I was an astronaut. I thought I've arrived in space. And I thought, wow, but this is a man, part of the work, and he needs to wear the protective clothing to look after him, because he's using the electricity, he's using sharp tools, and he needs to protect his hands, his feet, and his eyes, and his ears. All of these things need to be protected. As you go through life, there are many things going to come your way. Dangerous things. We must protect our ears, what we listen to, our eyes, what we watch and see, our mind, our feet, where we walk to, our hands, what we touch. So there's so many lessons whenever we think of the natural stone we can learn and apply to everyday life.
Did you enjoy that? Really, really good day up in the stone yard that day. And it's all about telling the good news, even from stone. Stone is like a rock, and Jesus is my rock. He's my salvation. Let's sing, Go Tell the Good News.
Anyone who believes, and you live by the habit of
the good news of Jesus Christ, his son, God's son. That's all for today. Have a really good day at school, at home, at school, and we'll be back tomorrow, every morning, 9 o'clock. See you.